Welcome back all of you. So in today's lecture we are going to do class 12th chapter 9 Kings and Chronicle, and this is the part 6. So as it is clear to you now that this chapter is all about the Mughal court, their administration system, the way of the living of the kings, and along with their way of living we also discuss the chronicles written by them. So in today's lecture we are going to talk about their capital cities. So one thing I want to tell you here that in the Mughals they basically built the capital cities like very in a royal way. So because that was the we can say heart of the Mughal Empire. तो जितने भी हमें फेमस सिटीज़ के बारे में पता है जो मुगलों ने बनाई थी लाइक दिल्ली, आगरा, फतेहपुर सिकरी, ऑल वर द कैपिटल्स अंडर द मुगल रूलर्स. सो फर्स्टली इन द टॉपिक कैपिटल सिटीज बेसिकली इट वॉज द हार्ट ऑफ द मुगल एम्पायर एंड बेसिकली इन द कैपिटल सिटी द कोर्ट असेंबल्ड. सारे मंत्री सारे वहीं बांटते थे. So the capital cities of the Mughal basically shifted from 16th and 17th century. Kabhi koi capital hoti thi, kabhi kai capital hoti thi. So it's a shifting one. So firstly, Babur took over the Lodi capital of Agra. So and during the 4 years of his reign, the court was frequently on the move. So he took the Agra as a capital. So during 1560 when Akbar came, so he also built the Agra fort. So you can look here. So Akbar built it. Constructed with the red sandstone quarried from the adjoining regions. So red जो sandstone थी वो कहाँ से मंगवाई थी? Near around region से उसने मंगवाई थी to build the Agra fort. So along with it, in the 1517 Akbar then decided to build a new capital. So Akbar was quite fed up with the capital of Agra. So later on he want to change it and to develop a new area. So that why he started thinking to make a new capital, so which is a Fatehpur Sikri. So one of the reason prompting this may have been that Sikri was located. Reason kya tha? Kyunki Sikri was located on the direct road to Ajmer, where the Dargah of Sheikh Mianuddin Chishti had became an important center of pilgrimage. So Fatehpur Sikri can be more rich and it is more convenient for the king to visit at the Dargah at the frequent rates. So next thing in our capital city, look at the monuments made by the Akbar in the Fatehpur Sikri. Beautiful architectural styled Mughal half. This is a Buland Darwaza of Fatehpur Sikri, and in the upper side there is a Taj Mahal in Agra which was built by the Shah Jahan. So the enormous arched gateways. So I wanted to tell you some glimpse that in a Mughal architecture there are some qualities like this one. This arch you can notice from here. This one is a arch, and one this one, another this one, and this one. These are the minarets, like Qutub Minar. So it's a like prominent feature of the Mughals, minarets. So this type chhatris they made, it's called chhatris, and dome meaning like this Taj Mahal, the upper side around semicircular round, it's a dome. So another thing, these type of windows which was used by the kings to give the to see the people and to see the audience, so it's called jharokha. So it's a jharokha. So these are also the architectural features of the Mughal. So I want to tell you that what is the reason behind to build the Buland Darwaza, because in 1585, so 1585 से पहले क्या था कि अकबर की एक विक्ट्री हुई थी गुजरात के ऊपर, जब उसने मुगलों ने विक्ट्री की थी. सो टू कमेमोरेट दैट विक्ट्री अकबर बिल्ट द बुलंद दरवाज़ा टू शो देयर पावर एंड प्रेस्टीज. सो इन 1585 देन ही ट्रांसफर देयर कैपिटल फ्रॉम फतेहपुर सिकरी टू लाहौर. सो देन लाहौर बिकेम द main center. So then Shahjahan persuaded sound fiscal policies and accumulated enough money to indulge his passion for building. Shahjahan was quite had a quite architectural love. So that's why he want to build a beautiful monument. So he had enough money for that. So in 1648, the court, the army, the household all moved from Agra to the newly completed imperial capital, that was Shahjahanabad. So it means that first capital, I want to remind you, was Agra, then Fatehpur Sikri, then Lahore. Akbar made Lahore the capital. Then after that is again Shahjahanabad. So it was the name of the old Delhi, Shahjahanabad. A name was on the name of Shahjahan. So it was a new addition to the old residential city of the Delhi. So with the Red Fort, so these are the prominent monument over there, built by Shahjahan. The Jama Masjid, a tree-lined esplanade with the bazaar, it's called Chandni Chowk. And spacious homes for the nobility. So this is all about the Mughal city. So next topic is related with the Mughal court. So basically, now we are going to talk about what emperor do. So basically, emperor begin his day at sunrise with personal religious devotion, prayers. Namaz ada karta tha. Then phir wo apni small balcony ke andar jata tha, jahan pe charokhe bane hote the, facing the east. So below, a crowd of people, soldier, merchant, craftsperson, peasant, women with sick children waited for a view darshan of the emperor to get the blessings of the king. And king gave the blessings through these charokhas. So it was known as charokha darshan. So he introduced the charokha darshan, Akbar introduced. With what objective? Objective of broadening the acceptance of the imperial authority as a part of popular faith. Because Akbar wanted that people should believe in the king and king should rule by the people. So he wants to create a people's rule. He wants to have his good image in the people's eye. So after spending an hour at the Charokha Darshan, the emperor then walked to the public hall of audience. It's a public hall of audience called Diwaneyam to conduct the primary business of his government. Aam kaam hote the jahan pe, isi wajah se use Diwaneyam kaha jata tha. State official presented reports over there and made requests to the king. If someone wants some mercy from the king, so then at that time, people made their requests at the Diwaneyam. So 2 hours later, the emperor was in the Diwanekha. So we are talking about the daily routine of the emperor. So 2 hours later, then emperor went to the Diwanekhas, hold private audience and discuss confidential matters. Meaning, khas tarike ke matters wahan pe discuss hote the. High ministers of state placed their petitions before him. Tax official presented their account. So this kind of a ritual, a king performed in a day. So this is a picture of Diwaneyam and this is a picture of Diwanekhas. Isn't it beautiful? So that's why Mughal were very famous for their architectural style. So another thing about the Mughal court, that on special occasions such as anniversary of the session of the throne, Eid, Shab-e-Barat, it's a full moon day of Shab in 4th and 8th month of Hijri era, Holi, the court was full of life. So the Mughal king celebrated 3 major festivals at a year, the solar and lunar birthdays of the monarch, Nowruz, the Iranian New Year, on the vernal equinox. On his birthday, the monarch was weighed against various commodities which were then distributed in charity. So basically, 3 main festivals the king ke, solar and lunar birthday of the monarch, king tha jo, Nowruz, New Year wahan pe celebrate hota tha, jo matlab Iranian New Year tha. Un birthdays pe kya karte the, king apne way ka jo bhi saman tha, ठीक है, वो मतलब वेरियस कॉमोडिटीज पब्लिक के अंदर क्या करता था, डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करता था. सो अनदर टॉपिक इन दिस इज़ अ टाइटल्स एंड द गिफ्ट्स. सो बेसिकली अ किंग ग्रैंड टाइटल्स वर अडॉप्टेड बाय द मुगल एम्परर्स. सो मुगल एम्परर्स बेसिकली वांट टू टेल यू वर वेरी फेमस टू गेन टाइटल. अपनी लाइक सुपरमेसी को क्रिएट करने के लिए उनके लिए टाइटल्स बड़े ज़रूरी होते थे, लाइक शहनशाह, कोहिनूर, ठीक है, सो सच काइंड ऑफ टाइटल. सो एट द टाइम ऑफ कॉर्नेशन और आफ्टर अ विक्ट्री ओवर एन एनिमी, जब भी उनको कोई कुछ गेन करते थे, कोई विक्ट्री करते थे, एट दैट टाइम दे वॉन्ट टू टेक द टाइटल्स. सो द ग्रांटिंग ऑफ टाइटल्स टू मैन ऑफ मैरिट वॉज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट ऑफ मॉडर्न पॉलिटी. और इवन किंग अपने कुछ जो पॉलिटिकल लीडर्स होते थे, अपने वजीर होते थे, कुछ मिनिस्टर्स होते थे, उनको भी टाइटल देता था. लाइक वी प्रीवियसली स्टडीड दैट औरंगजेब को एक टाइटल मिला हुआ था जिसको हम आलमगीर कहते हैं, एंड गिफ्ट्स भी मुगल एम्परर जो थे वो बड़ी खुशी से रिसीव करते थे. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट, एंड इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस इन अ डिटेल अबाउट द टाइटल्स एंड द गिफ्ट एंड द रेस्ट रिमेनिंग टॉपिक्स. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ वंडरफुल डे.